Hello everyone, this is Joseph. I'm coming to you by the power of the internet, or through a recording, or a live stream for those who are lucky enough to be around when this is happening. Today we're going to be playing Shinobido, Way of the Ninja. We're going to be playing a full, complete playthrough of the game. It's going to be on any percent. So this means, essentially, we just have to beat the game as quickly as possible. No difficulty requirements. Any glitches, exploits are completely allowed. And hopefully, if we play this very correctly, we should be getting a run that should be somewhat 1 hour, 20 minutes. How's it going, Mar? I hope you're going to have a good time today. We're going to be trying to play really well today. See, I'm normally not doing this run. I'm going to talk a little bit about my experience kind of speedrunning this game. Normally, I actually only attempt the true ending percent run. I genuinely felt it was an easier way to run the game because what you're doing is that you're not trying to kill any of the daimyo. Instead, you're keeping them all alive, and you're going to be trying to rush through all the games in the sequence.
Move the right analog stick to look around by pressing the R3 button.
I, for one, don't like to kill the daimyo. I find that
escape is sometimes a necessity.
I remember but we're getting used to that. I think it's always good
if
to
I ever forget how to do something
in the zone
I
where
can always check
you're
the
not
controls
really 100% confident with what you're doing, because it's a little bit of experimentation. So that wasn't a bad little first little tutorial castle there. So tell me, Mare. Forgive me for mispronouncing your name. Where have you heard about Shinobido? This is a pretty obscure game, as far as I understand. It didn't really have the particular type of pull outside of Europe and Australia, Asia. Australia is in Asia. So I'm always fascinating to hear where someone is coming into this this game series. Did you play the PSP game? We want to play this originally on the PlayStation 2. See, that's a little bit how I started playing this game. I was a Tenchu fan. Well, no, let me not say Tenchu specifically, because I know there's some super Tenchu fans out there. They really love the game. I was a Tenchu real aficionado. I enjoyed playing ninja games. Is closer to what I meant to say. Ninja games have always been a really interesting part of what I used to consider the Japanese gaming ecosystem. They don't really exist as much anymore. I'm sure many of us are quite well aware of the sad state in which ninja games have sort of fallen out of favor. But I love playing so many of them. Shinobido. Oh, you played on the PS2. That's great. That's fantastic. You actually have such similar origins to me. I wouldn't be surprised if you're probably from Europe or Australia, because I would be generally surprised if you happen to be an American who played this as a child. So we're just gonna talk a little bit about what just happened on screen. So the first mission we just did over there was called "I Need Your Help." This mission is a really, really quick a delivery mission. Getting into that room at the final portion is at the ultimate end. Getting spotted is not too much of a concern for us. None of the daimyo are going to be needed that much. So we can feel free to just kind of murder them as we please. So on this mission over here, instead of quitting out of the mission, what I do is that I walk into that well and die. By dying in the mission, unseen, instead of actually losing reputation with your daimyo, because they do not appreciate when ninjas quit missions, you actually gain reputation, which doesn't make a lot of sense, but it is the nature of how the game functions. By dying on a mission, they still give you at least 1 point of reputation. If I had to guess, I think they did that specifically as a way to balance the amount of punishment a player receives for failing a mission. It can be very, very painful to fail certain missions, especially when you have an inventory and it's full of high-quality stuff. We're just going to quickly head to the bottom of this to get salmon. Oh my gosh, there's a bear right there. Let's try to do some kung fu quickly, get the bear out of the way, grab the salmon, because that's worth some money, and then we're just going to evacuate from this situation. It's a little bit dangerous for us. So that's really all we wanted to do. We got the salmon, we completed the mission. Upcoming, the next mission should be the second soul fragment. There's a good chance Ichijo won't be the one who has that information for us. Another daimyo might give it to us. It is Ichijo, and it's in Honcho Shimoyozaki. Which is a fairly good location to do this particular type of mission. So the second soul fragment, normally it likes to spawn in the same areas where merchants will be sitting. This area, particularly over here, Honcho Shimoyozaki, has a big room in the center coming from the walkway, and in it you are able to have like a really quick direct pathway leading up to the treasure chest. So it should be in the room right in front of me. There it is. I'm just going to take this from here and proceed to the next port and right through the exit. So you can see this is a very direct line from the start of this mission up to where the treasure chest is. Every few moments I will do a little jump. The game, for some reason, calculates diagonal jumps even further than regular forward jumps, and it is a faster way of sort of moving between A to B. The faster way is to keep using diagonal jumps, so you kind of walk a little bit off skew from where you want to go, and then you jump diagonally in the straight line you want to go, and that's kind of the faster way of walking. We're just going to hit the split there. I forgot to hit the split. I apologize. I do frequently forget to hit splits when I am speedrunning. This is far too often that I am practicing without the splitter in front of me. Playing this game actually used to be... let me not say used to. I think playing this game still is one of my favorite things to do in the world. I love so much about this game. It does things that I personally haven't seen many other games attempt to do in such a very long time that coming back to it in this day and age is still somewhat of a breath of fresh air. The movement, anyone who plays this game will tell you about how finicky and sensitive the movement in this game is, but I for one find all of that completely attractive. I really love how sensitive the movement is because of the levels of control that it offers the player. Wow. And just like that, you can just walk into that room and get that execution, no punishment. I love being able to quickly shift left to right, being able to readjust my momentum in a few instances. It's the kind of stuff you see in only a few of modern action games. I think probably you'd see it mostly in FPS now, which is kind of unusual. Games like Doom, Doom Eternal. That game has a great movement system. It feels so good just to navigate in the world. And if it's not just about how good it feels, there's so much room for creativity. Even though within the game, you'll genuinely find yourself struggling to perform even the most basic things, you have such a wide catalog of options. It just requires that you as a player have to perform at incredibly high levels of play. I don't think it's particularly inviting for many people who are not new, who are new to these type of Japanese action games. You can definitely find the demands of this game being too high to have a good time. But I always say if you're willing to stick by it, you're going to see something that is absolutely one of a kind, unique, and really, really interesting. It's really interesting. We're just sticking with Ichijo for now. Hopefully, by the end of either this mission or the next mission, I think it triggers the Usuba Ageha fight. My splits, I just have it referred to as the Usuba round one. I don't even like to acknowledge Ageha. She is barely an entity in this game. So, yeah. Also, I did try to keep the labels for the splits somewhat short. And lots of skipping of missions. We're quite lucky in these instances because they're reconnaissance missions. We don't necessarily have to die in order for us to still be on our progression towards having a high reputation with the daimyo we're looking to get. So let me talk a little bit about the daimyo and the reputation of the daimyo towards getting this the end of the game. So what you're trying to do essentially is you're trying to get your daimyo to have somewhat like 65, maybe 75% reputation really, really early on the game, probably prior to the Kabuto fight. Because this will fast track a large portion of the bosses that you'll need. So we're sticking with only Ichijo's missions, even though some of them are a little bit slower than if I had to select another daimyo. I haven't specifically counted the time, but a portion of me does assume that if it is possible. Oh, he's right underneath the bridge. I should have known. Oh, that was a weird glitch. Part of me assumes that what you can do is you can probably accept at least one mission from the daimyo if you know there's a boss that follows up from it, just so you can get into that boss fight as quickly as possible. This is just minions. Okay, so blade like that, huh?
What are you doing here?
Wow, these guys are in our life quite different, aren't they? What's happening? Yep, turn around. There we go. And pushing onwards. Ooh, this is actually kind of killing me inside because we should have encountered that one interaction a little bit better, but it's fine. Let's proceed on to the boss fight. So this is going to be the Usuba Ageha boss fight. So once again, we're just going to talk a little bit about how this boss fight's supposed to work, if I do it correctly. When the boss fight starts, the two opponents, Usuba and Ageha, are going to be standing in neutral. Their AI only loads a few moments after you get controls, so you can make the first move before they can make any of their moves. We're going to take advantage of that by doing the instant whilst running attack. This is that whilst sprinting attack that you see, but there's going to be no real momentum gain from sprinting. It's going to pretty much pop out from like a neutral position. Once we do that and it hits her, she's going to be in a knockdown state. We're going to punish that knockdown state with the uppercut attack and send her body. Oh, that
didn't
happen. I was supposed to. We're going to keep trying to take advantage over the fact that she is in this instant state.
Are you ready? The enemy? Are you ready?
Got her. All right. That was a bit of weirdness that was happening there. But we managed to sort of go through. A bunch of that fight didn't work out as well as it was supposed to. There was an instance where, unfortunately, she did get invulnerability. So we weren't able to continue on with our combo. But it's okay because we're proceeding on with, I think, somewhat very good time. Thank you. these total destruction missions are probably not what I would consider the best usages of our time. They might very well slow down this run. So what I want us to do is to kind of move to the quickest well, which might be difficult to know. Oh, actually, we're very lucky to actually. So there we go. That's fine. Where we die this round, I believe we're going to be... We have an opportunity to die the next round again, unless we get a good mission spawn. But then the third mission after that, we will have to be alive. We are also looking for any instance where we can fight ninja and kill a samurai general there. This is not a bad mission to do. We might be able to get away with this very quickly as long as we can rush into that castle, head upstairs, and if we can't manage that stealth kill, we might be in big trouble. Normally on this difficulty, whenever you are fighting a samurai general, the biggest issue is not the general himself, it is the minions that are right near the doorway. Engaging with the samurai general will call the minions to join in on the fight, and their damage they do isn't sufficient enough to be a problem. It is more of a case of the amount of enemies on screen who continuously pester you, so you're unable to make any further movements except for just backtracking and running away. This like puts a hindrance on how fast the run can go, so you're always trying to avoid that. This particular route you're seeing I'm doing, this is also the same route you'll be taking if you are interested in trying to speedrun the game and you're picking up a gem.
Must have been an animal or something.
That Shinobi was being annoying.
What?
Okay. Everything is kind of working out so far. And there we go. That's exactly what I was hoping would happen.
The enemy. Someone! Anyone!
I'm having a lot of issues with these AI guys. Really in a lot of trouble right now.
Don't think you can stop me.
Oh boy.
See?
Got him. Oh boy, that was absolutely madness. Jesus. If I had a mine, I think I would have been in a better position, but you know how these things go. Oh well, at least Akame's lost a samurai general, so I feel like that might somewhat be useful to my overall goals, but this is still not really what I need at the moment. So it's not this, it was not that one. So sorry.
Talking to a fool is so tiring.
So far, there's some very, very legitimate issues with the run. Okay, just looking back. We got him. So that's good. So now we have the option to go steal the glowing stone. This might be easy as long as everything goes correctly. Sometimes there's a minion that spawns in this grass. Today there's none. Just have a peek in the overlook out here, just to see what kind of goons are standing. There are no goons, so that's pretty good. That guy killed. Proceed onwards into this area.
Oh yeah!
Well, that's pretty lucky. What? We're gonna have to get out of here really quickly, because we're in big trouble.
What?
We're gonna be in very big trouble very soon. I don't know what we're gonna do about the situation.
Come
out! I
think
we're just gonna get in trouble. This is really funny. I can't believe they haven't detected us yet. I don't know what's gonna happen in this situation.
Search every corner.
Alright, they're like deciding, okay, there's nothing
Stay
here,
in your position.
Let's just go back. Everyone's going back. I don't really want Ichijo to know I'm out here, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of a bad look and shit. Oh boy. Okay, that's good. I guess wait for him to go out. Wow, there's some AI stuck in the pathway. Oh my god. Alright, YOLO.
What? I can hear something.
Intruder! Probably here.
Run! But you can't hide!
I can hear something.
Chase
them! I can hear something.
Thingy. Can't reach it.
I can hear something.
There's no way
halt!
That...
Halt!
Just
Intruder!
Move.
Where are you?
Jesus Christ. Yeah, look, I think it's at this stage, we're gonna have to admit, run's dead. I know, it kills me a little bit. It kills me a little bit. Because, you know what I should have done when I killed that, Yojimbo? I should have picked up his body. I should have picked up his body and moved it. I shouldn't have like run into the room and then gotten the I shouldn't have run into the room to grab the actual gem. What's going on here? Okay. We can make this work. We just gotta, you know, not play like how we were playing just now. Just securing his position. That's good. Then there's this guy over here. He's always a problem. It's a good thing he wasn't leaning against the wall, so we were lucky in that instance. We've got the stuff. we can probably make our way out cleanly. So this is a little bit closer to what it's meant to look like. We really wanted to force it before, but all we really did was hurt ourselves. We just gave ourselves a pretty rough time.
Is it true? The village was destroyed?
Okay. That guy. And then, Bob is your uncle, right? So that's the gem. It's a good thing we didn't kill one of Ichijo's, like, samurai generals, because I know Ichijo wouldn't like that. He'd be very upset with us. But Ichijo's the kind of guy that doesn't really complain too much about these kind of things. He's a very, very sort of forgiving person. Okay, let's just make sure the items we need are just in the right position. And then it's time to go into the garden. And one of the things about easy mode, unfortunately, comparatively to very hard, is that the spike traps cannot kill you very quickly. They take a very long time for them to kill you. So you cannot, like, use the spike traps to quickly go into a death state. Instead, you will have to wait for the mission start screen, and then you'll have to press start, and then you'll have to go quit, and then you'll have to press hide and let the enemies pass through. The enemies will pass through. They will not steal anything because it is all on our inventory, on our person, and we can just proceed as if no one was even there. Like nothing at all. Nothing at all. Nothing at all. Stupid shikshi Flanders. See, I always find this portion of the game so unsettling because you spend like a lot of time not really knowing how you're going to actually defeat one army or the other because, you know, they're not really making big moves to go attack each other. But it all kind of falls together in the end, which is good. And another one bites the dust. It's another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. So if we're lucky, what we're going to get is one of those reconnaissance missions from Ichijo. He's like, oh man, I'm sad that you died. Why don't you have a break? Go do some recon, bro. And then we're going to be like, thanks. So then we do the recon, and then hopefully we should be getting that Zaji fight. Eats. Another one batch dished. Another one batch dished. There we go. And that's the Zaji fight starting right now. So there's no real special tech for fighting Zaji at this difficulty. Essentially, you want to get your judo flips and then your upwards uppercut into downward stroke. Pretty precise. Whenever you find Zaji's at a bad distance, you can just throw some shuriken just to pepper him. That'll just keep the pressure up and it'll help you kill him slowly. You don't have to bring his health to absolute zero for the fight to actually end. So whatever you can do really helps. He's being like that. And we got him. I think definitely one of the issues I had was not taking a back step in order to reposition for the second uppercut. Zaji had consistently gotten out of the attack loop. So I might have to go into practice and just make sure I can do that attack loop correctly. So that's Zaji done. Steel rest from the enemy. So that mission will actually get me to kill Ichijo, which I don't want to do. I would rather they send me a mission that allows me to kill someone like Akame or Sadame. You see, if I do kill Ichijo at this stage, all the work that we've done will be erased. Okay. I think we will be getting a cutscene. No, we're not getting a cutscene. We are waiting for Kabuto to send us a message to say, to challenge us. Secret documents through the woods. And we're just walking through the woods. Ichijo isn't really giving us very great missions currently, so we haven't had the chance to do very high-paying assassinations, no barbarian assassinations, no bear hunting, which is fine. We don't actually need to do any of that stuff, but it does sort of make things easier. Now, this is the Kabuto fight, so if we're good, we should be able to get Kabuto in a few moments. All the daimyo are currently alive. That is a little uncomfortable, but it shouldn't worry you too much if you are running this. Getting that salmon and then crossing into the threshold of that stage, triggering this cutscene here. What you can do when this fight starts is that do not immediately hit Kabuto with the uppercut, but instead hit him with the judo flip. The judo flip actually resets him back into his first position, so Kabuto will keep trying to do his axe throw. So let me see if I can demonstrate that. So the axe throw begins. It's not going to start there. Got a nice little pepper there. And then he begins his bullshit now. Okay, the axe throw is gone. Oh, that was it. That was it. That is exactly how you do that fight. Jeez. That was a massive save in time. That was just a really good save in time. Okay, so now we still have kind of low tier missions from Ichijo. He's still not making big money moves. And we're waiting for him to suggest we attack one of the ninjas. When we do attack those ninjas, we can then get the fifth stone. If I had to guess, it's probably going to be one of the Mosu twins. Ichijo generally, as far as I'm concerned, he's scared of Akame, so he only wants to attack Sadame. Or you could really reinterpret that Ichijo is very much focused on trying to end the war against the Amurita cult, which, you know, that's what the game starts with, is Ichijo feeling absolutely defeated because he couldn't find a way to actually stop the Amurita cult for pushing for war. Sadame, for someone who speaks entirely about the Amurita for so long, it's very rare that you'll actually ever see her talk about what it is that the Amurita does. So this is the kind of missions we want. Before we do this mission, I'm going to purchase some items. These are the first items we're purchasing in the run. So we're going to be getting don't know, actually. I forgot entirely. Mines. That was it. Mines. Oh my gosh. I actually forgot what I was buying. I really thought I wanted to get a potion, but I don't know where that idea came from. I don't know why I'm buying a potion. And we're going to do this and this mission here, steal the food from the enemy. This mission is very particular because there's two areas where the ox cart can spawn from. The ox cart can either spawn from the bottom of Rokudo Valley, which essentially means that we're going to be spawning on the opposite end, or it can spawn on the top, which is the same case. Hopefully we're at the top. In this instance, we are at the top, which is good, which means we can essentially just make this distance here, and then now we are pretty much in position for the fight. This might be an issue because the most ninja are quite
good.
They really love causing a lot of damage quickly, and
Down, down, down.
Got there's her.
No net. Now gem, we got ya.
Which is a shame. So, it doesn't matter. We'll try and blow up these ninjas. Can. Don't think we can. Okay, we
get after them!
Try to blow him up again. Okay, that's him. And that's the last one. Alright. I was hoping we would actually get something a little bit more useful. But, you know, that's fine, that's fine. We checked to see if they had the fifth stone. They didn't have the fifth stone. So that's a little bit of, you know, a precaution just for the future. So we know that, we don't have to rush so much in order to actually get that fifth stone. Here's the garden defense mission. Might particularly, I want to see if regular. So there's still no regular. Still no regular strong landmines. I want strong landmines. They're very, very good. Probably one of my favorite items in the game. Oh, right, the garden. I actually forgot. Do 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 do. How am I feeling for time? I feel like we're kind of doing okay. Feel like we're doing okay. So we go, we're just, you know, we're living like Go. What is Go? Go's a quitter. Go quits. It's what he does. There we go. Here's the stone. I generally thought the stone was going to actually be in the hands of one of the hands of the ninja, but we're going to be stealing it from a castle, so let's go do it. Stealing from Murokomi Castle is usually a little bit easier than stealing from Congo Pass. Congo Pass being where Kame's base is. Oh, this is almost the God's one. I walked into the fire. That was pretty funny. Let's see, is there someone up here? No, we are very lucky there's no one up here. Let's proceed onwards towards this end of the area. We jump on this rail, chuck this little guy. This is going to alert Big Boy over there.
Uh-oh.
Couldn't care less what Big Boy has to say. Go on, tell all your friends. And we're just going to proceed onwards out of the base. Boom goes the dynamite. There we go. Let's hit that split. Send to recipient. Skip that cutscene. I know y'all love cutscenes. I love them too. They're very funny. But speedrun requires me to proceed onwards. And onwards shall we proceed. Let's see if we can buy any of the heavy landmines yet. No, we cannot. That's fine. We'll proceed to then waiting for Uzumushi to challenge us, which means we have to go through at least 3 missions. So I think the first mission we can die, which will be faster than actually completing this, because this is what, like, assassination. Tell you what, because I know y'all love watching people fight bears. We're gonna assassinate the bear anyway, because it's cool. I don't really care how much time it's taking. It's cool.
Intruder.
Okay. I understand.
You're not going to get away.
Where are you? Oh, he had to, didn't he? He had to. Look at him. He was showboating. Come here. Oh. Wow, I would have died actually if this was very hard mode. Where is he now?
Is it the enemy?
Get him. He keeps doing this to me. Like, I'm at the edge. Why are you here? He's somehow knocking me off. I'm the one trying to knock him off. Wow, he's actually... He's trolling me big time now. The big boy. And there we go. And that's it. That's how you get it done. I mean, that was absolutely a giant waste of time, but I can't get over just the experience of a judo flipping a bear off the side of a mountain. I think it'll be my downfall. I promise you that. Okay, so that's the first cutscene we have to encounter. You'll recognize when it's the final cutscene, because you'll see that shot of Happy Tombo's prosthetic arm weapon, the one that kind of stretches out. It'll be on the floor. And that's when you know the mission starts. So, oh wow, that was actually, what the hell? That was only one cutscene. You can actually just do one? I'm not complaining. I'm just surprised is all. It was really like that, huh? I guess this is part of why I love the game so much. It is because it has so many weirdnesses to it. Just has so many weirdnesses to it. This is the route I normally like to take. This route allows you to go through being undetected. I created it with the idea that one day I might do a complete run of this game, no detection. I think that's a crazy idea, because the way this AI is absolutely against you, the AI will sometimes detect you in ways that it shouldn't. But I find the whole concept really fascinating, that you will be able to play this game truly as a ninja, and not just some sort of a brute or thug that goes into battlefields and just sort of slashes and hacks away, you know. Someone with real finesse, dexterity, and precision. I think that would be beautiful, but ultimately I don't think most people ever really are able to play the game like that. It's just not really how it looks. Okay. So, Heavy Tombo sometimes will not actually fight back. He will just watch you kill Uzumushi.
It's very fast. It does it. Very lucky. We get the shuriken kills. And there we go.
Nice and easy. You know what I should have done? I actually should have jumped away whenever I saw Happy Tombo. Uzumushi was swinging his big heavy weapon. I should have jumped away and then started throwing shuriken at Happy Tombo. Okay, so right now we are very much interested in taking out some samurai generals. Because we need to get the daimyos at least at one general. Because if they have two generals, the game will not allow me to kill them. For some reason, I will keep killing the clones over and over and over again. No matter I go into this daimyo's home. I kill the daimyo. I find out it was a copycat. Until I take out at least one of their generals, they will consistently keep getting more and more copycats. It does not matter. These missions can be also very tough. Very, very, very tough. I'm gonna try to maximize our advantage by keeping stealthy. But doesn't actually matter too much. Let's get into it.
Is it an intruder?
Side.
I need some help! I need support!
And we got it. For some reason, the AI cannot find a way to get directly at you. They're always kind of like struggling to close that distance, but yeah, for some reason, I don't know. With this challenge, Sadame Supply Corp. Another mission that I think is not going to be that tough. I'm sure it's going to be quite fine. We're looking to see mission end and have Zaji appear at the end so he may fight us. All this extra work is clearing the daimyo's schedule so that when it is time for their deaths, they are open and free to receive them instead of reluctant and ready to negotiate for special leniency. I, for one, do not care. Give special leniency to
you.
Guards, what are you doing? I need some help!
Got him. For a few brief moments, I genuinely was quite scared about what was going to happen to me. I was on the edge. And flipping Kabuto like that, that was really lucky. That was really lucky. Alright, with this money, let's see if we can buy some strong explosives. So there's only one in the market, but there's two if we get camouflaged, which I'm going to spend. There's improved shuriken, which I'm going to buy two. We're going to switch from the regular to the improved. And then with the last of our money, we're going to get super strength potion C. This will make what we do when we assault the ox cards go by a little bit faster, a little bit snappier, and that's going to make everyone happier.
That was an unintentional rhyme. I didn't mean to sound so corny. Okay, more samurai generals need killing. Stroll in the forest. I think it's technically fine if I slowly but surely work through all the samurai generals. Like, I don't actually know if this is the best thing to do, because I feel like I should be dying at this stage and not actually trying to kill these samurai generals.
Listen, brother, I've come for your head.
Glory to Lady
Sedane! The grapple, what an annoying AI. I'm unconscious.
Glory to Lady Sedane!
Dad!
Okay, that just kind of cleared the room. I just needed some space. Oh, whoopsie doodles. I just did it. You know, Shuriken was actually so much easier than, like improved Shuriken was, like, so much easier than just, trying to fight him. You can easily kill the general in less than 1 minute, you know? I believe you, 100%. I definitely believe you. I just actually, don't think I have the, finesse and technique to actually pull it off. At least not at this stage in my, sort of, playthrough with the game. I'll have to sort of work on my technique a bit more, and maybe read up a little bit more too, and I probably will be able to get that. Okay, borrow some rice from Akame. Finally, this is what we've been looking for. This is exactly what now it's time we can go into Akame's castle. We can kill Akame, and probably by the time Akame has been killed too, because this is a borrow from the rice, we're not going to fight Zaji. So that kind of like makes us a little bit backwards. But that's fine. We don't actually necessarily need to fight Zaji. We want to kill the daimyo. That's really the key thing here, is killing the daimyo. So once we head upstairs and kill Akame, we're gonna quit mission. And that's fine.
There's been a lot of ninja around here lately. Is there something going on?
There's how you kind of clear walls. Ah. Oops, that was not what was meant to happen. Excuse me? How did you see me? What angle were you even looking? Is he even in his house?
He's gone.
He is.
It's you.
Where are you?
We're invincible.
Someone out here.
What are you doing here?
Die here.
Okay, so he's dead. And let's quit the mission. So now we should open up our mission checker to see who's alive and who's not alive. We can check to see what the condition of the young man is. Okay. And Akame should be dead. That should not be a clone. That should have been Akame actually dead. I believe the first time you attack a daimyo, at any instance, the first time you attack them, they never have defenses up, and it's always the real one. Let's just go into the garden and die and quit. Let him go through.
I might actually change the splits then. So after Uzumushi, it is Zaji. So I'm just going to write that in my notebook really quickly. Okay, let's hit that quit. Mm-hmm. Sadame or Akame. So just checking on the info here. And yep, Akame has died. And then find the hidden rice. We don't want to do that. We don't want to do that either. These are all kind of bad in honesty. So we'll try to do this one. Because what we're trying to do is we're trying to fight Zaji. We want to fight Zaji in that 1v1. So if we can free Sadame's troops, hopefully this will, one, give us the access to fight Zaji. And two, we might potentially even find the ninjas with the seventh stone. Every now and then in these total destruction missions, you can find shinobi, and they will have one of the gemstones. This looks like it is just a generic fight sequence, so we don't have to worry too much about getting anything particularly productive. Don't look at me, brother. Don't look at me, man.
Someone! Anyone!
Get him, please.
Count!
Can you get rid of him? I keep pressing that button.
This isn't going well!
Oh my gosh, a boost shuriken just trivializes so much of combat. It just trivializes it. You don't even have to engage at all. Just like buy 99 of the mugs and, you know, Bob the Uncle. Where is AI? What are they doing?
What could this be?
What? What?
Dad.
There you are!
That was so sloppy. I understand if everyone is quite unimpressed with that display. Me too, folks. Me too. I'm also thinking about it going, oh my lord. Oh my lord, what was happening? Okay, Zaji. His name was Zaji. He likes to fight, but he's not that great at it on easy mode. Nope. Because Zaji cannot get around the fact that he's AI, and AI only activates a few moments after the players get their controls. So you're always guaranteed that first initial attack. Oops. And then end it now. Very, 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 very simplified fight. With the improved shuriken, you really don't even have to think about engaging in a fight. You just have to knock them over, do one uppercut combo, and then follow up with the shuriken. No stress, no mess. If they ever do another one of these games, I believe they should make improvements on how well the AI responds to projectile pressure. Stealing a rice from Sadame. We will do that, but we need to make sure that she has one general. I know she has the one now, but I just want to do a little experimentation seeing as how we're here. I'm going to attack Sadame right now anyway. I'm going to attack her, and then I'm going to proceed to see if she has a clone. I believe it is a clone. I believe she will have a clone, but I want to know if by having one general, that affects whether she'll have a clone or not. Because from what I understand, I need to do Killer Whale's Eye first. So, yeah, what's going to happen is that this is going to be some save manipulation in order to keep the time down. So what I do is that I play this, my real game time is going to keep running. So the real game time is going to be longer than what we have on the save game time. And when we enter real game time, when we look at our save game time, it's going to be significantly lower than our real game time. And that's going to be because we're doing this particular exploit right now. So this tower over here is where you steal something, and the tower on the in front of us, that's going to be where she is living.
Why did I do that?
Oh yeah, I don't know if you guys know how to traverse up these platforms here, but that is what you do. You okay?
You
what?
Super.
How did I get this confused?
Hey.
They even got the Asuka! Someone! Anyone!
This shouldn't have been where Sadame's thingy is. It was.
Weird.
Well, that's funny. Oh my gosh. That attack actually is so annoying. It's so annoying. It can end something. Oh my gosh, I hate that attack so much. I actually am trying to dodge it. I'm genuinely attempting to dodge it, but
Glory to
Amorita. No, that wasn't her. That was a clone. That was definitely a clone. So when we exit this and we head back into the main game, you're going to notice that she hasn't died. I believe if the clone says glory to Amorita, that is the stunt double. But if she says no, not like this, then you know it's the real thing. Okay. So technically, we're going to end game and then reload the game. So it's going to reload the game from right before we did that mission. This is Ninja Master 52. It's going to reload that. And then instead of choosing that Sadame mission, because I do not profit off quitting that mission, I actually do want to consistently do more damage to Sadame's army. I believe it increases the odds of you getting a higher chance of assassinating her. Or perhaps I'm mistaken. Instead, what I should have done was assassinate her twice. The first time for... No. Definitely not, actually, when I think about it. Because I would have actually had to... Yeah, no. I actually think this is probably the better way to do it. This tree... The amount of times I've actually ran straight into that tree, it's really funny. Whoops. Oh well. You spotted me. Hey, where'd you go? Can I kill him? Let me kill him!
You can't!
Oh, game.
Everyone, attack!
Can I kill him?
I heard that.
Is it the enemy?
What is it?
Huh?
Ha! 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 You're not gonna get away.
You guys are being very unfair to me.
What's that say? I heard them. I heard them.
Kidding me, right?
You're not gonna get away. I'm not bad.
You know if you throw the exploding the chicks, it explodes on the map. So you have like a dedicated like explosive that can be done like right from point blank. It's very, very crazy, right? Like that was ridiculous, right? I don't know how you play the game, but to me that was ridiculous. Just kind of force your way into any and every situation with bombs. Okay. Bar rice for Sadame. So this is another Sadame mission. I do want to spend my money soon. So, gosh, there's no good landmines. We're going to buy some more improved shuriken because we've used a significant amount of it. The next level of the strength potion isn't in the shop yet, so we don't have to think about that for now. Oops, I didn't actually want to be here. That was a bit of time loss. Don't worry, sonnies. We can lose a little bit of time every now and then. You know, it's no big deal. Don't be too upset, friendos. We'll be alright. Okay. Okay, so let's understand this correctly, team. What we're going to do is we're going to get onto the roof. We're going to get onto the fence. Run along onto the fence up until we reach that big green hill. We're going to then run along the green hill and do a grapple hook to put ourselves up in that position. Grapple hook onto the first tower. Head to the second floor of the first tower. And then we should be able to rush upwards and kill Sadame. It should be all planned, meticulous, scientific, technical, all that jazz. You know, what we're trying to say is we know what it's meant to look like. Let's just hope it actually comes out as we're all hoping. So this tower here should be where Sadame is. Oh my gosh, I mean, here. Can you get the flip up? Just get the shit out of you, bastard. Just chilling around. How much security did you get, lady? Is this because, like, about what happened last time? Because, like, I can do it again. Oh, look at that.
Fine.
Ooh, you just got killed.
Take a back step. And
she's gone.
And now we can just quit. And if she's gone forever, then that's good. But we technically can't actually kill her until we get Killer Whale's eye. So I'm an idiot, is what I'm saying, actually. That's actually what I was saying. We can't kill Sadame until you get Killer Whale's eye. What were you thinking? Why are you doing that? I just need to kill a trader's merchant. I should understand that better now that Oh wait, no. I can't get Killer Whale's eye because I don't have the seventh stone. That's what I need. I need the seventh stone. Oh my gosh, I actually totally forgot. That's how you get it. Okay, so, some security here. Sadame's army is basically finished. It's now just up to us to kind of polish it off. Let's see. We've got one guy up here, so we're going to try a different route. Because we know that might end in problems. On this balcony, there's
any
rations
going? Guy,
but there's no one today. Kind of come through this way here. There's no one through this doorway here, so hopefully this should be the merchant. If it's not the merchant, then oh, luckily there we go. And that's that. I need to get that seventh stone.
Wow, that's so weird. I think you have to steal the stone from Sotei Tower. I think that's where you have to steal it from, which is going to be a problem for me. Because, like, I might actually get into a lot of trouble. No, I just have to remember. I think it is upstairs on the tower on the left. So not the first tower we're going to. We're going to go to the next tower. The one, the second one. I believe if we look in there, we will find the gemstone. I'm so hungry, soldier says. In his belief, he had not eaten in days. Lady Sadame promised them they would have sushi. But instead, all they've had is tears. There's goons on those rooftops. See him. Bastards. There it is. Boom. Oh, you, right. Forgot. What's your name?
Nothing.
Catch me. Where is the exit? It should be right here. Ah, there you go. Nicely done. Alright, that's the seventh stone. Now it's time for the killer whale's eye. I don't know what we were doing before. Just going into Sotei Tower. Just being a silly little goose. I believe I do need to do Killer Whale's Eye before I can get her. Let me just open up like a previous speedrun, because I didn't write down exactly how it was meant to work the first time. I'm a little unprofessional. You'll have to kind of excuse me while I just get a video opened. The audio shouldn't bleed into this YouTube video. Quick. I don't know what you guys think. I thought that was pretty quick. Can I get Killer Whale's Eye? Am I doing something? I just don't know why I'm not getting Killer Whale's Eye. I should have gotten it by now. I think I'm supposed to, but just like not always 100% sure. It might be something like three missions after you recover the first soul gem, and then you can get Killer Whale's Eye. I think that might be the case, but every now and again the game just gives you missions really, really fast, and then sometimes it just gives you nothing. Okay. It's time to kill Sadame once more. I know you love seeing it.
We do pretty much this whole run with the short grapple hook. This is always like an issue whenever I play this game for like a long time. I just feel like progressively my skill just drops and drops and drops, and I cannot do as many precise maneuvers or complicated maneuvers as many times or as successfully. Let's see. She still brought a bunch of goons to this place. Oh, Sadami. Just wish you would, you know, be cool and not invite soldiers to this thing. Let's go.
Glory.
There we go. I believe that was her? She sounded like she had the right dialogue. Cutscene looked good. I think that was a good sign. Although it's not the final cutscene, because we should be seeing. Okay, enemies in the garden. This is probably people here to rob me, if I'm not mistaken. So we're just going to buy some strong landmines, because finally, you know what I'm saying? Your boy earned it, and there's no Asuka shuriken, but we're going to get improved shuriken. And then we're just going to equip these boys. Oh, that's camouflage training, strong landmines. Maybe I should have gotten like a bit more of those exploding chickens. They're pretty good, those exploding chickens. They're like explosive spheres, except they're a little bit more consistent with how many you can get a day. And you don't have to do any alchemy to make them. Just buy them straight from the shop. It is weird how they explode on impact. I mean, I understand there are explosive fake chickens, but just figured there'd be something a little bit akin to plastic explosive. You know, plastic explosive does not just sort of blow up because you threw it. It's not like dynamite. Half your money was stolen. Right. Find the hidden rice. And protect the supply part. Provisions. So, yes. We're still kind of waiting for Killer Whale's Eye to spawn. Not really much to say. Destroy enemy ox carts before they can escape. You're a ninja, man. Why are you getting yourself in all that trouble?
Hey, brother. What happened? A ninja's life is not something you can understand.
I found them.
What happened?
Guards, what are you doing? I need some help!
Oh my god, I'm locked in animations. Okay.
I need support!
Can you believe those two fell off a cliff on their own? I wasn't even fighting them, they just rolled off the cliff. And get this alert box down. I'm doing something wrong here. I'm definitely doing something wrong here. Perhaps I'll just kill myself in this mission. It might be faster just to kill myself. After you get the seventh soul fragment, it just might be faster to keep killing yourself. So we're gonna use strong landmines because I believe this is actually... Oh, nope, that still didn't kill me. There we go. It's a little bit faster than sometimes finding a well. There we go. All right, you got it. I think it will be in our best interest the next time we attempt this after we get that seventh soul fragment. Do not make attempts on the daimyo's life. Don't do it. It will not result in a... It will not result in a kill. You must just push on. Just keep dying. You don't even have to win those missions. Just keep dying. And then soon you'll get Killer Whale's Eye. We'll proceed through Killer Whale's Eye. And then top it off with returning to human and kill Gamoran.
Well, well. What? Right. Is it the enemy?
That cutscene is normally very funny to watch. It's a shame we won't be watching it. You know, speedrunning and all. She ain't get no DMs from me. So, here's a little bit about how this fight's meant to work. We knock the young lady down, and then proceed to hit her with whilst crouching square. That immediately does the raising arms attack, and from a knockdown, that should guarantee the kill. Completing the mission like that, so I just need to hit the split there. Sorry, I forgot again to hit the splitter. I was too busy talking about what it is that we did just now, because what we did was very, very quickly. It'll be much quicker than our experience returning to human. Do 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 do. He's a bear. Yes, he is. Yogi Bear. Hey, it's me, Onji, your best friend and talking cat. I'm just here to tell you. Please remember to make sure that your animals are spayed and neutered. What sort of voice would Onji have? I always imagined, you know, as a cat, you'd always have a very dry and, you know, a little bit of a sing-songy voice. Like, oh yes, you are my friends. Ah, it's been so long since I've had a chance to enjoy watching a ninja perform his absolute duties. And, you know, obviously Go, I'd imagine Go's voice, he would sound, you know, somewhat like his British voice, but he's meant to be a little bit of an edgelord. Gotta be honest, Go's thing is like he's an edgelord. So I imagine his voice would sound either really similar to something like Sasuke from Naruto. You know, that sort of serious voice. Maybe even a little bit like Zoro's voice from the One Piece anime. I think that kind of like fits into how Go would sound. The cutscenes are relentless, eh?
You just sitting there, and they're just bang, 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 cutscene after cutscene after cutscene. It's like, enjoy it now while it lasts, kids. It might be your, might be the end of it. Borrow rice from Sadami. So, what is our favorite game, folks? Killing Sadami's clone! That's right. How many young girls have been recruited off the Japanese streets, given the promise of living like the queen of the Amarita, Lady Sadame, in the Tower of Sotai, only to end up murdered by an unknown ninja assailant who didn't even stay long enough to even steal the rice he came to the castle for? The numbers are very high, but they are never too high for us, because it's what, folks? Let's kill Sadame's clone! I love this show. Alright, so, for this first episode, we're going to be looking at our contestant. Her name is... ma'am, what is your name? I'm thinking of a Japanese lady's name. My name is Momo. Well, Miss Momo, today, welcome to Let's Kill Sadame. You're going to be playing Lady Sadame inside her Sotai Tower. What do you think? How do you think you're going to do today?
I think I'm going to do okay. I feel as if I've really sort of practiced my Lady Sadame impression, so if I have to fight, you know, I'll do pretty well.
They always think they'll do well. All right, and who will be challenging her? Oh, and it looks like it's the Shinobi from the Asuka. Go the Crow! He is a specialist in stealth arts, and his ultimate weapon, known as the shuriken, has met no match. Let's kill ourselves with this bomb. And I believe that should be the death of Sadame, because she used the dialogue of, "No, this can't be." I believe that was her death. But I've been quite wrong for like the last 30 minutes, something like that. So do not expect a man like me to know any of what I'm talking about. Oh no, that was her, actually. That's the final cutscene. When you see the cat playing with the automated windmill, then you know the end is drawing near. And so we have $1,000, and I don't believe there's anything I can purchase that will make my life any easier. But I don't know, I'll buy the sphere of confusioning. That seems... I never use the spheres of weakness personally. Oh wait, no, it's too expensive. It's too expensive. There's nothing else I have in the old thingy, so that's fine. Let's get into this. Let's kill the boy, Gamuran. It's been a long journey, folks. It's been a very tough ride. We had some ups, and we've had our downs. Oh, have we had our downs. But I hope you're feeling excited, because this is coming up to the climax. Everything we've been working for, everything we've been talking about, it's all coming down to this. Go of the Asuka has reclaimed the last soul fragment, and now he knows clearly that the only way to save Ukataka is to go through the evil wizard Gamora. But how can Go, a simple ninja, fight an immortal wizard who has been the scourge of an entire country? Well, because Go has a little something called the help of his friends. And by the help of his friends, I mean Zaji's going to get thrown mid-air, and then he's going to land directly on a spike and get impaled through the body. Sorry, Zaji, but look, your sacrifice really made all of this worthwhile, brother. So if we do this fight correctly, it's going to be the same Kabuto-style fight. Alright, we did not do it correctly. There we go, got him. So he managed to get out of that loop, which is a little annoying, but it's not the worst case scenario. Now we just have to go get Gamuron round one.
Ha 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 ha! Go, you fool! You think you are powerful enough to stop me?
You know, Gamuron reminds me of. I think he's like he's a lot like Shang Tsung from the Mortal Kombat series.
Stop being annoying.
Stop being annoying. What have you done? Gosh, the Gamuron running around like a little circus performer. Jump! What is he doing, man? I'm trying to have like a thing here. You know. You gotta love this AI. All right. So, let's try to get that. There we go, we got the instant. Wait for him to get up. Punish. Throw them on the flip. Punish. Throw some on the Can you guys notice that Go's actually switching his sword? Oh, this is so annoying. You can actually break out of it if you use the dash buttons. So when he's doing this, he's invulnerable to projectiles. That's so annoying. Like a grail. There we go. That's the end of the game.
It's a clothes rail.
Yeah, so that's it. 132-27 on the final hit. Yeah, what'd you guys think about that? You know? That's the timing on our last save, I'm pretty sure. So there we go. There's a scenario clear right over there. 1:21:29. Which is not bad. Not bad at all. It was about something like 11 minutes of difference from real time and in-game time. Which is normal because we did reload the game after we attempted that Lady Sadami fight. So we can probably do better than that, which excites me because that just means we have to run it again in the future. So there we go. That's pretty much that. I'm going to end the recording here. I hope you guys enjoyed the speedrun and enjoy the rest of your day.